Assalamu alaikum dear friends, this is Sajid Ali. Today is my first lecture after introductory lecture. The topic under discussion before you, Muslims in India. First of all, Muslims came to India through trade and commerce and through the coast of southern India. And why Arabs conquered Sindh? What were reasons behind it? First reason, plundering of Muslim ships. Dear friends, some Arab merchants lived in Ceylon, now Sri Lanka, died there. And the king of Ceylon sent their orphans and widows to Arabs with some valuable presents, but they were plundered by Sindhi pirates. Sindhi pirates हम उसे कहते हैं जो समंदरी चोर होते हैं. In table. Debel is a seaport of Sindh. Muslim ships full of widows and orphans and valuable presents were plundered by Sindhi pirates in Debel. Those widows, some of them, wrote a letter to Arab Sultanate. Their Islamic state, Caliphate, Khilafat. So Hajjaj bin Yusuf, Hajjaj was a governor of Iraq. In reply, Hajjaj wrote to Dahar. Dahar was Raja Dahar. Raja Dahar was a ruler of Sindh. Hajjaj wrote to Raja Dahar to leave orphans and widows and send them to Islamic State Arabs, but Raja Dahar refused and Hajjaj decided to attack on Sindh. Dear friends, Muhammad bin Qasim is a nephew and a son-in-law of Hajjaj bin Yusuf. Muhammad bin Qasim conquered Sindh in 712. Muhammad bin Qasim conquered on the order of Hajjaj bin Yusuf. Before Muhammad bin Qasim, two expeditions were sent by Hajjaj bin Yusuf to attack on Sindh, but they failed. Muhammad bin Qasim at first reached Debel. So in 712 he conquered it. It was the first success of Arabs. And then Nehron, Seven, Rawar, Brahmanabad, Arod, Multan. In Rawar, Muhammad bin Qasim met with Raja Dahar, who was the king of Sindh, and fought with him on 28th October 712 AD. Muhammad bin Qasim defeated Raja Dahar and killed him, then captured Rawar fort where his widow Rani Bai committed suicide with his 15,000 fellow women. After Rawar, Muhammad bin Qasim went to Brahmanabad where he met with the son of Raja Dahar, Jai Singh. He defeated Jai Singh and then Arod and Multan. Multan was the last point of Arab conquered. In this way, Muhammad bin Qasim conquered Sindh and Muslims settled in Sindh permanently. Umayyad dynasty, what is Umayyad dynasty? Umayyad dynasty, it is a Umayyad Khilafat. Umayyad is a tribe. Dynasty means a family rule. This is a Khilafat rule from 712 to 750 in Sindh. When Muhammad bin Qasim conquered Sindh, at that time Umayyad dynasty is the Islamic Sultanate, Khilafat. So there were 9 governors changed because Muhammad bin Qasim was not a ruler, he was a governor. When he conquered Sindh, he was appointed as a governor in Sindh, but he was asked to come back. And Abbasid dynasty from 750 to 855, Sindh became the part of Abbasid dynasty. There were 31 governors were appointed in this dynasty in Sindh. And after 855, Muslims or Sindh became independent and divided into petty and small states. Mahmud Ghaznavi. Mahmud Ghaznavi, before discussion of Mahmud Ghaznavi, I want to share with you about Alptgin. Alptgin, who was Alptgin? Alptgin was the founder of Ghaznavi dynasty in 962 at Ghazni, Afghanistan. And when he died in 977, he was succeeded by Sabkatgin. Sabkatgin was the father of Mahmud Ghaznavi. So Mahmud Ghaznavi is the ruler of Ghazni dynasty. Mahmud Ghaznavi came to India 17 times. In other words, Mahmud Ghaznavi attacked on India 17 times and destroyed many temples and looted money and jewelries, decorated his own empire in Ghazni. As a result of his attacks, Punjab, Sindh and Multan became the part of his empire, Ghazni empire, and Lahore became the center of Islamic culture. Mohammad Ghori. Mohammad Ghori, after Mahmud Ghaznavi, Mohammad Ghori established his empire. Mohammad Ghori had no son, his own son, but he had thousands of slaves. Mohammad Ghori conquered many regions of northern India. He also established Muslim rule in India. That's why he is called the founder of Muslim rule in India. In conquered regions, Mohammad Ghori appointed his own slaves as a governors, as a viceroy. Tajuddin Yildiz was appointed as a governor in Ghazni, Afghanistan. And Nasiruddin Kabacha in Multan and Sindh. Qutbuddin Aibak was appointed in Delhi and other areas in northern India. So dear friends, in this lecture we have discussed how Muslims came to India and why they came to India, what were reasons behind it. Inshallah, in second part of this lecture we will discuss about Delhi Sultanate. Thank you very much, and if you want to watch my next video. Kindly like, subscribe and share my channel. Thank you very much. Take care. Allah Hafiz.